dig. Vi leben in finsteren Zeiten. We live in dark times, as the German playwright Bertolt Brecht put it. 82 years ago, Hitler's Germany, supported by most of Europe, attacked the Soviet Union. Today, the collective West, led by the United States, has attacked Russia. On the 9th of May 1945, Hitler's Germany capitulated. Fascism had been defeated for good, people around the globe believed. No one thought in 1945 that fascism would rise again, but they were wrong. In 2014, the Western countries supported a coup d'etat in Ukraine that resulted in the installation of a rabidly anti-Russian regime that exposed the ideology Hitler Germany was based on. This coup regime waged a terrorist war against the population of eastern Ukraine, which resulted in the killing of thousands of civilians, including children. To fight the war, the Ukrainian regime used right-wing nationalist groups that openly declared that they considered the people of eastern Ukraine to be subhuman. Nevertheless, the Western countries sent weapons to the coup regime, and the United States openly encouraged the regime to continue the war. On the 18th and 19th of February 2022, the forces of the Kiev regime launched a mass bombing of Donbas in what was clearly the preparation for a military attack. Russia was thus forced to initiate its military operation to defend Donbas. Had Donbas been captured by the forces of the Kiev regime, this would have resulted in the massacre of tens of thousands of people, and hundreds of thousands would have had to flee to Russia. It was the duty of Putin and the Russian leadership to prevent a genocide. Today, Ukraine has been transformed into the battlefield of a proxy war between the Western countries led by the United States and Russia. American authorities have openly declared that they want to defeat Russia and divide the country. Europe has capitulated politically and makes no attempt to oppose these irresponsible plans, which, if the situation gets out of control, could result in nuclear war in Europe. We truly live in dark times. But the situation may not be as dark as it may seem. The US-led West is today much weaker than it was in the 1990s and early 2000s. In the 1990s, the West could wage a terrorist war against Serbia and destroy Yugoslavia with impunity. In 2003, the United States, supported by a handful of allies, destroyed Iraq in a war of aggression contrary to international law, despite the fact that almost the entire world community was against the war. Today, states such as Russia, China, and Iran constitute a real power factor militarily and economically. And the aggression, arrogance, and stupidity of the United States and the West, for example, in relation to the Taiwan issue, have driven them into each other's arms. These states, which stand for equality and respect for international law, are supported by the overwhelming number of states and people in the world. The US-led West finds itself in many ways in the same situation as Hitler's Germany in 1943. It is losing the global power struggle. And that makes Western leaders and Western mass media desperate. Something the campaign of lies and demonization against Russia and the Russians in Western mass media is a clear expression of. Hopefully, the Kiev regime will collapse soon so that the war in Ukraine will end. But we probably have years of conflict and war ahead of us before the United States and the Western countries realize that they will have to settle for a new world order based on the equality of all states and international law. What we can all do, what it is a moral duty to do, just as in the 1930s and 1940s, it was a moral duty to contribute to the fight against fascism, is to support states such as Russia, China, and Iran that are fighting to free themselves from Western hegemony and to create a more just world with all our ability. Thank you for your attention.